Hello, this is lovely Lovebird Designs, and today I'll be showing you how to make a double loom hummingbird. This one is the original, and I used metallic bands, and also this one is the second one I made, which I made more gray on the belly, and it's blue. And this one is metallic purple and regular black. And the feathers over here are metallic green and like a metallic grayish. And this is regular blue with metallic blue. So today's bird, I'm going to be using Rainbow Loom dark green and Rainbow Loom metallic green. And I'm going to use them just like that. So one of each instead of the blue or the purple. You also need a red, because it's going to be a ruby throated hummingbird. And also, this is just light gray, but for this tutorial I'm going to use one light gray and one silver. So, and it's all the Rainbow Loom metallics. It's a mix pack. So we can get started. I'm going to use green for this bird that I'm making, but you can use whatever colors you'd like. And also, we're going to make a wing at the end. And if you don't want the wing, you don't have to make that, but it looks pretty cool without the wing too. So we can get started. And black is also for the eyes, the beak, and the legs. Okay, so you will need one regular green and one metallic green. And it's a double loom, straight configuration. So we'll put the greens here. So whenever I'm using green, it's one metallic and one regular. The metallic is because the hummingbirds are very shiny. So it's a very nice characteristic to use some metallic bands in this. If you don't have metallic, you can just use regular colors. Still will come out beautiful. So we'll put three here. Then we're going to put one down here, one stitch. And I'll try to make it as slow as I can so we can just make everything perfect. Okay, so one, two, three here. One, two, and three. Okay, now we're gonna do one more over here. I'm going to bring it across. I'm going to bring one more across here. Now we're going to do something a little different. We're going to do diagonal, sorry. Okay, then we're going to put another set of bands connecting these two pins. Okay, and this is the head area. The beak we're going to do off the loom. This was originally a triple loom bird, but I condensed it to a single. Now we're going to go into the red. I'm using two of the metallics. If you want to use one regular and a metallic, you can do that too. So here's the ruby part of the bird. I'm going to bring it to two pins. Push these down. Now we're going to do another green. I just want to make sure that I have one regular and one metallic. Okay, another green right here. Okay, we're going to do another red here. Double red. Another double red here. Okay, another double red here. Okay, and then another green. Now we're going to, I want to make the chest of this a little bit more red. If you want to keep the red like this, then keep it just like that. But I want to make one more stitch red to make it a little bit more fuller. So instead of putting a gray here, I'm going to put a red just to make a little bit more. But if you don't want a more red throat, you can just put gray instead. Okay, now we're going to start on gray. And I'm going to use one light gray and one silver just to make it a little more shiny. And then green over here. Okay, next we're going to do gray on this row. There's a lot of colors with this bird. A magnificent bird. Okay, one, two, another one of gray. Okay, and then we're going to do a green right here, and then another diagonal of green. Now we're going to continue with gray. Right here, we're going to put green. And then green, green. Now we're going to do gray over here. Another gray. And And then another row of green. One more set of gray. Another gray here. Okay, the rest green. Now we're going to go diagonal with the gray. And one more gray here. Okay, now green. Now we're going to do another diagonal of green. Put another green right here on this stitch. And two more stitches of green. So now this is the tail area, and I want to put a stitch going this way. This is going to be the little tricky part, because I had a triple loom, so I had another row here, so I'm going to make the tail on a diagonal, but it'll work out. So we're going to connect these two pins with one stitch. Now we're going to take another green and bring it on a diagonal, just like that. You know what? I'm not even going to do that. I'm going to do something. You know, I think we'll just work with that too. It's easy. It's a little bit easier than what I had thought. Okay, so that's one of the tail feathers. Here's number two. Number three. Okay, so take a single green, you can use metallic or your regular green. Wrap it around four times around. So this is your basic layout. Now we're going to put feet, which I'm using black. And I'm going to use the hook to make the feet. and it's going to be 3 stitches plus a gray to mesh into the bird. So you take the hook, wrap this around 4 times. This is your number 1. Take a single, twist it upon itself. Here's number 2. Single, twist upon itself. Number 3. So, 3 black and 1 gray. Single twisted. And that is 1 foot. We're going to place that right here. Okay, we're going to do the same for the next foot. Single, wrapped 4 times around. Single twisted. Single twisted. Okay, so that's 3. And then 1 gray, single twisted. And you place it on that pin. So now we're going to make the eye. You can use a bead, or I'm going to use a band. Wrap it around about 6 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, take a green, just 1 single green. Place that on the green. Make sure it's the shape of an eye, a little circle. Now we're going to place it on this pin, connected to this pin. Okay, just like that. Okay, now we're going to put structural bands. I'm going to take 1 single green and place it just like this. And that will create a little fray in the tail so you can separate it. Then I'm going to place triangle bands going up the green part. These are all single bands. Now we're going to go into gray bands because we have gray in the front. These are all singles. Now we have a red part right here, so I'm going to use a red metallic. And I will be placing it just as so. So the red will show in the front over here. Then another red. Like that. Now to connect these two pieces, I'm going to do a single green. I'm going to connect these and leave this be. Single green, twist it upon itself, and place just like that. Okay, and I'm going to do 1 more single green right here. Twist it upon itself. And that should bring everything together. So you have green on this side, the gray right here, and the red right here. Now we can start looping. Pay attention to the pattern of where the looping is, because it's a little tricky up here and a little tricky right here. Okay, we can start. And I'm gonna just bring this row up first. And you know what, I'm gonna put another little structural band here just to tie that together too. So take one single and place that there. Okay, push this down and we'll start looping up. We'll bring that on the diagonal. Now we're going to start on this row. Okay, so this is the tricky part. We're trying to grab this one right here, so it should be right underneath. So that should be the first one. That to the side. Now I'm going to start on this row of the tail feather. Back on there. Now we're grabbing this band. It'll be on the bottom. Okay, we'll loop forward to this pin. So now we're going to stop right here because this gets a little complicated up here, but it's easy once you get the hang of it. Now we're going to grab this guy. Loop forward. Now we're in the red part. Okay, we're going to stop right there. Now we're going for this diagonal pin. Okay, pull that out of the way, and we're grabbing this band. It's the uppermost band. Forward. Okay, we're stopping right there. Oops. Now finally the chest area. And we're grabbing this band. There's a lot of bands here. It's the lower two. So now comes this part. We're going to loop all of these forward, then we're going to loop sideways, then loop again forward, and then sideways again. So I'll show you how to do that. Take this red first. Then the second red. Now green, and this green. Okay, so now we're going to take this and loop to the left. The uppermost bands. Okay, now we're going to grab this band on the left. It's very thick in this head area. So take your time. And loosen it up a little bit. Okay, now we're grabbing this band. Now, this one should be the lowermost band. Now, this one, lowermost band. Okay, this one, lowermost band. Okay, finally we're going to go up across. I'm just loosening the bands here too, so they don't snap. And finally this guy. Okay, this is what it should look like. Now we're going to make a beak, but off the loom, and you'll need black. So first I take a double black, I'm going to place it just like this, take your hook and grab the other end, pull it through, Now you can either secure this with a toothpick, or if you have another hook, you can do another hook just to keep it like that. Or if you have any clips, you can put the clips there too, just to secure this, which I think is a great idea. I think I'll just do a clip just to be safe. Okay, now we can slowly take it off the loom. Because we're using a metallic and a regular band, they're two different thicknesses. So when we take it off the loom, you have to really stretch it out and make sure the bird is in the right position. And I'll show you how to do that too, because it might look like a mangled ball when you take it off. So it's a little thick here, so be careful taking it off here. Okay, set the loom to the side. Stretch it out. Make sure the eye is prominent. Pull it out a little bit. The head area. Stretch it out, because that might be a little mangled up. My blue bird that I have, I really had to stretch it out really good to get the two rows prominent, and then you can see the inside parallel rows. Okay, and this is your tail, and you can see the bands in the back have to be stretched a little bit too. Okay, and that's that. Now we're going to work on the beak. And the beak is special because it's pointy. So we have a double band right here holding the clip. So place your hook through. Okay, now you can take your clip off. Take a single black band, we're going to use four of them. Single twisted. Just like that. Straight. Single twisted. Single twisted. Sorry for all the loose bands. Another single twisted. Okay, so that will be the thicker part of the beak. And we're going to take one more band. single twisted. Place it just like that, and we're going to make a slip knot. To make a knot right at the end. And to make the beak pointy, what I just do is I take the two ends and tie knots. Just like that. So you can keep on tying knots until it's at the end of the band. Okay, see it's getting a little longer and pointy. Okay, so I'm at the end now, and you can either cut this with a scissor, or you can take one loop and place it over this one, so it's like a little point right there. So I just placed one loop over the other, and this is the hummingbird, and then I'm going to make the wing separate and then attach it. And the wing is pretty easy. So if you just like it like this, you can keep it like that because it shows like a wing right here. But if you want the wing to be prominent and more 3D, I'll show you how to do that right now, which is really fun and easy too. So we'll take just the color green or whatever color you're going to use. Same with the metallic and the regular. Okay, place three. This is a single loom, but I'll just keep the double attached. And one more set of three. And then we're going to make it into two. So metallic and silver, and we're going to bring this guy on a diagonal to make it more condensed. So one, two, three, and then we're going to bring it to the singles. So we'll bring that on a diagonal. So one, two, three again, and we're going to do a cap and band. And I'm going to do metallic for this one. And four times around. Now I'll take a single band and single twisted. This is just like that. Single twisted. Okay, single twisted right here. And then right here is triangle. And that is your wing. Okay, so now we can start looping. If you wanted to make two wings, you can have it on both sides of the bird too. I'm going to grab this diagonal band. Okay, I'm grabbing the diagonal. So this is your wing. Now I'm going to take three bands. And I'm going to just do slip knots at the end. Okay, just like that. Now I can take it off the loom. Okay, put the loom to the side. Okay, so now, sorry for the music. this is your wing. I stretched it out, and you can see it's shiny because it has some of the metallics in it. And you just find a position on the bird where you want your wing. And I'm gonna put mine just right here above the chest area. You can see that this is just the plain with no metallic, so it's a little bit lighter, and I added the metallic here. So I'm gonna put in this stitch, put it through. You can take one of the loops and just pull it right through. Okay, now I'm gonna going to be more of a diagonal like that, you can see. So I'm going to put it through another stitch, get the other side, pull it through, and then finally I'm going to place it right here. Okay, so you have three bands coming out. And you can see I put it on a diagonal so the wing is coming out like that. So what I just do with this, I just take one band and the two, and I just tie a knot to secure it. Very easy, and it'll stay in place. And I did a double knot. If you wanted to do two wings, you can do the same thing and place it on the other side, and then just hide the excess bands or cut them and hide it underneath the wing. And you can also take a C-clip and secure the wing to the body too. And this is your green hummingbird. Stretch it out because it has different bands in it. Also, I put, if you want to make the feet with it, take two bands, two blacks, place it through the bands at the bottom of the foot, and you have your claws. Just like that. I'm going to put a clip here too, just to see how that looks. Okay, so it's secure right there. And if you wanted to make another one, you can place it on that side too. And stretch out the beak. If it comes out like that and you don't like the ends, you can cut them too. So I'll cut these. Okay, so here are your hummingbirds. And this one has less gray, so it's more colored on the bottom, but these have the gray. So this is the solid, the metallic and the gray, and just colored on the bottom. Okay, and I hope you like the tutorial. Please subscribe to Lovely Lovebird Designs, and we'll see you soon. And then green. Now we're going to do gray over here. Another gray. And then another row of green. One more set of gray. Another gray here. Okay, the rest green. Now we're going to go diagonal with the gray. And one more gray here. Okay, now green. another diagonal of green. Put another green right here on this stitch. And two more stitches of green. Okay, so now this is the tail area. And I want to put a stitch going this way. This is going to be the little tricky part. Because I had a triple loom, so I had another row here, so I'm going to make the tail on a diagonal, but it'll work out. So we're going to connect these two pins with one stitch. Now we're going to take another green and bring it on a diagonal, just like that. You know what? I'm not even going to do that. I'm going to do something. You know, I think we'll just work with that too. It's easy. It's a little bit easier than what I had thought. Okay, so that's one of the tail feathers. Here's number two. Number three. Okay, so take a single green, you can use metallic or your regular green, wrap it around four times around. So this is your basic layout. Now we're going to put feet, which I'm using black. And I'm going to use the hook to make the feet. And it's going to be three stitches plus a gray to mesh into the bird. So you take the hook, wrap this around four times. This is your number one. Hello, this is lovely Lovebird Designs, and today I'll be showing you how to make a double loom hummingbird. This one is the original, and I used metallic bands, and also this one is the second one I made, which I made more gray on the belly, and it's blue. And this one is metallic purple and regular black. And the feathers over here are metallic green and like a metallic grayish. And this is regular blue with metallic blue. So today's bird, I'm going to be using Rainbow Loom dark green and Rainbow Loom metallic green. And I'm going to use them just like that. So one of each instead of the blue or the purple. You also need a red because it's going to be a ruby throated hummingbird, and also this is just light gray, but for this tutorial I'm going to use one light gray and one silver. So, and it's all the Rainbow Loom metallics. It's a mix pack. So we can get started. I'm going to use green for this bird that I'm making, but you can use whatever colors you'd like. And also we're going to make a wing at the end, and if you don't want the wing, you don't have to make that, but it looks pretty cool without the wing too. So we can get started. And black is also for the eyes, the beak, and the legs. Okay, So you will need one regular green and one metallic green, and it's a double loom straight configuration. So we'll put the greens here. So whenever I'm using green, it's one metallic and one regular. The metallic is because the hummingbirds are very shiny, so it's a very nice characteristic to use some metallic bands in this. If you don't have metallic, you can just use regular colors. It still will come out beautiful. So we'll put three here. Then we're going to put one down here, one stitch. And I'll try to make it as slow as I can so we can just make everything perfect. Okay, so one, two, three here. One, two, and three. Okay, now we're going to do one more over here. I'm going to bring it across. Okay, I'm going to bring one more across here. Now we're gonna do something a little different. We're gonna do diagonal, sorry. Okay, then we're going to put another set of bands connecting these two pins. Okay, and this is the head area. The beak we're going to do off the loom. This was originally a triple loom bird, but I condensed it to a single. Now we're going to go into the red. I'm using two of the metallics. If you want to use one regular and a metallic, you can do that too. So here's the ruby part of the bird. I'm going to bring it to two pins. Push these down. Now we're going to do another green. I just want to make sure that I have one regular and one metallic. Another green right here. Okay, we're going to do another red here, double red. Another double red here. Okay, another double red here. And then another green. And now we're going to, I want to make the chest of this a little bit more red. If you want to keep the red like this, then keep it just like that. But I want to make one more stitch red to to make it a little bit more fuller. So instead of putting a gray here, I'm going to put a red just to make a little bit more. But if you don't want a more red throat, you can just put gray instead. Okay, now we're going to start on gray. And I'm going to use one light gray and one silver just to make it a little more shiny. Okay, and then green over here. Okay, next we're going to do gray on this row. There's a lot of colors with this bird. It's a magnificent bird. Okay, one, two, another one of gray. Okay, and then we're gonna do a green right here, and then another diagonal of green. Now we're going to continue with gray. Right here, we're going to put green.